In this short video, I will show you the best way and the easiest way to add B-roll to your footage in Descript. B-roll is extra video that you may want to add on top of your main video, your A-roll, and even applies to music and even applies to pictures or anything you want to add on top of the video to maybe illustrate a point. If you know what a B-roll is, I don't need to explain it to you. So to add B-roll in Descript is quite easy using scenes, but I'm not going to even do that today because this is an even easier way to add B-roll like I'm going to demonstrate. I have a video here of me doing a tutorial about Premiere, and it's already imported into Descript and transcribed. And if I expand my timeline, by the way, if you don't have it, you can click down there to expand your timeline, and you can see that I have no scenes in here. I just have the one piece of video from start to end. 13 minutes. So I want to add some B-roll at different times. And the easiest way to do is just to create the scenes and define where the scene starts and ends and then drop your B-roll in there. But I have an even easier way, and this is going to be the end of the video, really. You just make a selection in text, and let's suppose that I want to add a B-roll for the phrase in here in the script. So the script allows you to make selections, and then you can do things to those selections. So in this case, I'm going to use selections to add B-roll, because this is actually the very easiest way to add B-roll that starts and ends at an exact moment that you want. And it's really useful for portions where you want to fill an entire video. Maybe you're creating a sales video where you just have the audio, no video. So then you turn your composition into a video composition, and then you just select the different portions of it and just add the B-roll on it. So let me show you how to do this. I have made my selection, which means my B-roll, whatever it is going to start from the word I'm going to show you, and it's going to last this one behind me right here. So this is the entire phrase that I selected, one sentence. And to add the B-roll is very easy. Go to the top and click the media bin, open it up, and this is where you will find your files and B-rolls and stock media and things like that. But let's suppose that I want to add a video from the stock media. Not a problem. Go to videos and just search for something. I searched for software, so I'm just going to choose one of these videos. And you see the videos, they show you the duration, like 17 seconds, 10 seconds. Doesn't matter what it is, because that selection, you're going to see what it does. It's going to limit the duration to that portion only. So with my selection already still active, I will grab the video. I don't even need to download it in advance. Grab the video and drag it, and don't release your mouse. And you can place your video on top of the selection you made. And it's going to tell you that it's actually going to add it to that range, because the selection becomes blue and you look at the bottom, it says add to range. So that means Descript is going to add that video that I just dragged in that particular selection and release your mouse on top of that blue selection. There it is. Now Descript is downloading the media. You can see it in the corner, and there we are. And look, this is the media that I was just adding. And if you look on the script, you will see now two scene boundaries created before and after my selection. So that is really cool. Descript created the scene for me and placed that video in there. And if I zoom in on the timeline, you can see this is the video that I just added, and it's going to start at the exact time that I did my selection. Let's play this.
It's going to be amazing. I'm going to show you how you can create a gradient background like this one behind me right here. And not only that,
and as you can see, as soon as that selection or the scene is done, it comes out of it. Now, what if you want to adjust the beginning and the end points of that B-roll clip? Because, of course, if you're doing videos, you're going to have to change your mind sometimes and make them shorter, longer. It's not a problem. Two ways to do it. You can actually adjust that particular scene. So in scene number two here, you see that this is where my clip is. I can click on this little thing on the timeline here, above the timeline, really, next to the scene thumbnail, and just drag that. And I will change the beginning of that clip like this. And another way to do it is to actually click on the edge of the clip, and you go down there and you notice that your mouse is changing to like a bracket kind of icon. Click that and that will change the beginning of that clip. So plenty of flexibility there, even after you added your B-roll, to adjust the beginning and the end of the clip. So there you go. I'm going to snap it back to my scene. And the same thing you can do at the end of the scene, grab this little separator here and move it there. And that makes my video kind of last less because I'm making that scene shorter. And finally, a last tip for you. If you want to change where the clip actually starts and ends, not to change its duration, but I want to change the part of the clip that I'm seeing, because right now my duration is like 6 seconds here, but you remember the clip was like 12 seconds long. So if I want my clip to actually play at a different segment, but in the same duration, in the same place, there is a tool in Descript called the slip tool that allows you to slip the clip inside of that selection you made, inside of that clip you delimited in your scene, but slip the beginning and the end like this, just like you're moving something through a funnel, through a hose, or water through a hose or something like that. I don't know how to illustrate this, but it makes it easy to shift the beginning and the end of the clip while keeping the ends of the clip untouched. So let's see how that works. You go here, and as you can see here, at some point the screen on this video starts to scroll up for some reason. I would like maybe my clip to actually begin there. So select your clip, go to your slip tool on the right side. It's called slip. You can also press Y, activate the slip tool, and watch this. Now I click on my clip and drag it left. And when I release, it's actually the scrolling part starts earlier like this. And this is actually easier to see on a music clip. So let me just do that. And let me add a music clip again on a selection like this. Let's suppose that I want to do a music clip like an outro. So I go all the way to the end of my composition right here. And you can use your shift mouse wheel. And here we go. This is where I would like to have my music, but I want a music to fade in actually part way through the clip, just as I'm finishing talking right here. So I'm going to make a selection again. So let's say select the last sentence of the tutorial and the end of it. So you see, I selected from here all the way to the end, and I'm going to go to the media bin. I already have a file, a music file imported called Little Pastry. It doesn't matter what it is. I will drag that music again, the same thing, drag the music on top of the selection you made. Don't drag it down here. You can do the same, but don't drag it there. Just drag it on top of your text selection. The selection becomes blue, and it tells you that it's going to add that music to that range. Release your mouse, and there it is. The music starts in the exact point I told it to. For music files, Descript doesn't create scenes because they're not visual elements. They're just audio tracks. So then, but it still cuts the video short in that point. So here's the thing. I like to use this at the end of my selection of my compositions and to illustrate the slip tool, because look, the music actually was added from the beginning. And if I play the music,
very much for watching. And if you find this,
it just starts at the beginning. But what I need is I need the ending of my music, because when I become silent here at the very end, I would like the music to stop. I would like the music to end there. So I need to reach the end of my music track. So this is where the slip tool comes in very useful. And watch this. I will click on my music track and make sure you're on the slip tool. And watch this. As I am dragging, you see the music kind of moving inside of that segment. That is what the slip tool does. It allows you to adjust the beginning and the end inside of that range that you defined. So I'm going to actually scroll all the way to the end because I want my music to end right here at the end of my clip. And I don't care about whatever happens at the beginning, because that part I can actually click and fade that in right there. Create a fade in. So now my music is going to fade in, starting at this place, fading in, and then it's going to keep playing until the music actually ends on its own. So I am doing this with the slip tool, just slipping the music clip inside of the selection I made. So I know this was longer than I thought, but the easier way to add B-roll, music, logos, images in a specific place, starting and ending at an exact place, is to use a selection in text first. Of course, that requires your transcript to be created, so the file that you're using as your main A roll or the main script track needs to be transcribed, and then you use the text to make selections and quickly build and add B rolls. So I edit sales videos sometimes, and all I get from clients are audio recordings. So I just place an audio recording in there, I transcribe it, and then I have maybe a half an hour clip with just voice. So then that makes it very easy to just go and hunt for B-rolls and make selections. When someone's saying something relevant that applies to that B-roll, I make a selection, drop the B-roll in, and move on. So that helps you to quickly fill up a clip or a video with B-rolls, just perfectly placing them at the right time you want. So I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching so far. And if you would like more learning in Descript, Camtasia, and all the other software that I'm using, then you can maybe consider signing for my Media Makers Club membership. For a one fixed monthly price, you get access to all of my courses, including an 8-hour long Descript storyboard course, a few mini courses, a lot of courses for Camtasia, and a lot of downloadable assets, advanced access to YouTube videos, and also Q&A sessions, and free access to my webinars. So all of that is included, and the link is in the description down there. So thank you again for watching this video, and I will see you on the next one.